GHS. I'm Sarah, live from quarantine.
And I'm Ty, and this is the news for September 20th through the 24th.
For lunch next week, we will have chicken strips on Monday, chicken with rice on Tuesday, popcorn chicken on Wednesday, Bosco sticks on Thursday, and a chicken sandwich on Friday.
The homecoming dance is Saturday night from 8 to 10:30. Tickets are $10 and can be purchased at lunch all this week.
This week is homecoming. Here's Chloe and Brooks to show us how we're dressing up. Alors on danse. Alors on danse. Alors on danse.
Alors on danse. Alors on danse. Alors on danse. Alors on danse. Alors on danse. Alors on danse. Et là tu dis que c'est fini, car pire que ça, ce serait la mort. Quand tu crois enfin que tu t'en sors, quand y en a plus, eh ben y en a encore. Et c'est la cycle des problèmes. Problème ou bien la musique, ça te prend les tripes, ça te prend la tête. Et puis tu pries pour que ça s'arrête. Mais c'est ton corps, c'est pas le ciel. Alors tu ne bouges plus les oreilles. Et là tu cries encore plus fort, mais ça persiste. Alors on chante.
I can do that.
I was totally confused by it. I'm like, where's your
Friday is our homecoming game against Elkins. Show up, dress up, and cheer for your Lions. Let's all climb into the Suburban and join GHSTV on the fifth stop of the summer road trip. Here's Emily to take us to the Momentary in Bentonville.
Did you know that approximately 100,000 individuals visited the Momentary on just their opening weekend? That includes 91,000 online and 13,000 on-site. Today we are here at the Momentary to learn more about the story of its incredible creation and to learn how it's impacted the community.
The Momentary opened to the public on February 22nd of the year 2020. It was founded by the Walton family, and it's considered to be a new contemporary art space branching off of the Crystal Bridges Museum of American Art. Each individual that has been given the opportunity to experience this amazing exhibit has said to have really enjoyed it. Here are a few of those people's reviews. The service, decor, and atmosphere were great. The view and sunset were spectacular. Truly a one-of-a-kind place to enjoy a posh setting with some friends and family. Super cool place. The entire property is an experience. Lots of art on the outside and inside as well. As you can see, the Momentary appears to be a big hit, so take some time and pay them a visit.
Grab your family, your friends, and maybe even your neighbor, and come on down to the Momentary, because I'm positive that there's something for everybody.
Thank you, Emily.
Do you ever wonder what goes on in clubs that you're not a part of? Here's Preston to tell us more about FFA.
FFA being one of the biggest clubs in Gravette with over 50 students, most students still don't know what FFA is. So I'm here on the inside to tell you all about FFA.
Future Farmers of America, also known as FFA, was founded in 1928. Gravette FFA started the club 21 years later in 1949. There are many things to do in FFA, such as welding competitions and judging. Twice a year, we sell blue and gold, which is sausage, bacon, and chicken. FFA has a national convention each year. This year, it is being held in Indianapolis. The FFA National Convention is a place where FFA members come to participate in competitions and workshops. Vendors from all throughout the United States come to show their newest products, such as farming and welding equipment. Some even bring simulators to show off new farming technology. Traveling and being part of the convention allows students to explore different career options and opportunities through FFA.
So if you are interested in joining FFA, you have to be enrolled in one of Mr. Landon's classes.
That's all for this week. I'm Ty.
And I'm Sarah, and we'll see you next week.